Welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be a very fun video featuring my two kids, William and Elizabeth. If you guys do not know, we just did a video on Elizabeth's channel. It's Elizabeth time prior to this, so I will have that video listed on my description box. And be sure to subscribe to her channel as well. But that was a fun video to do, and today's video is my kids pick out the makeup that I'm going to be using for today's look. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy this video, and I don't think I've ever featured them in my video before, except Elizabeth maybe, I'm not sure. I know Stella definitely, but I don't remember having them two in my channel. So I hope you guys enjoy this video. If you guys are new to my channel, welcome, and if you guys have not done so already, please be sure to hit the subscribe button down below so you guys can stay notified with everything that I post on my channel. So yeah, if you guys want to see what all the makeup that my kids picked out for me to use during this video, then let's just go ahead and get started. Okay, so in this bucket are all of the makeup that my kids picked out. I will insert a clip right now to show you guys what they did. They both had a lot of fun. I was going to include Stella, but it was her feeding time, so she was drinking her bottle while the kids were quickly picking out their makeup. I had each of them take turns for each category to pick out what they wanted for mommy to use for this look. Pick out the palette, but I had them pick out three palettes because I guess they, you know, just for me to have a variety of. And this one is actually pretty good because I did include this in my recent favorite video. If you guys have not seen that, I will list that down in the description box. But this is also a face palette, so it's an eye palette and also a face palette. But the other two are eyeshadows. But yes, I was going to do a voiceover, but I haven't done a talk through in a while, so I figured I might as well do a talk through and chit chat with you guys, let you guys know what's been going on and all that good stuff. So yeah, if you guys want to see what kind of look I can come up with all of the makeup that my kids picked out for me to use today, then let's just go ahead and get started. I don't know which way, but let's just go ahead and get started. Okay, so I'm first gonna go on. I'm first gonna start off with foundation, my face first, and I'm gonna use a primer that I received in, I believe, my BoxyCharm, I think. But this is the Smashbox Photo Finish Foundation Primer, and I've never used this before, so I'm hoping this is good. I have a combination normal combo skin, so I'm gonna try this out, but I've had a really great things about this, and this is a travel size, so we'll see how I like this. And it's just like a silicone clear primer. So I'm just gonna dot this all over my face. Okay, right now it feels different from all the other primers that I've used. It dries down to like this weird feeling. But I'm hoping this is good for a normal combo skin. So we'll see how it goes. You know, my baby is just sticking out. If you guys don't know, I just had a baby 7 months ago, and postpartum for me was really crazy, especially the hair loss. I did go through a postpartum hair loss this pregnancy, and now I lost a lot of hair, but now my hair is just starting to go back, and all the baby hairs are starting to come out. Okay, so for foundation today, I'm using the CoverGirl Vitalist Healthy Elixir Foundation, and I am in the shade Buff Beige. I did do a review on this foundation. I will link it down in the description box or on the screen over here. But it comes with a pump, and I really love this foundation because it lasts all day. And it's like a semi-matte finish, so it's not over-drying or anything like that. And I think the color for me is pretty darn good. I bought this from Walgreens or CVS, I'm not sure, but I got a pretty good deal for it on it. So, in the video where I did the review on this, I did state that I like using this foundation or applying this foundation with a brush. And that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to apply it with the It Cosmetic Love Beautifully Foundation Brush. If I forget to mention the names of the foundation or the brushes that I used during this video, I will always have it listed in the screen over here. So I'm just going to buff this out and just apply this all over my face. The foundation is buildable. I think for the first layer, it's like a medium to full coverage. But if you really want a full coverage, you can definitely build it up. Okay, so for concealer, I'm going to be using my all-time favorite, William actually picked this out. And this is the Tarte Shape Tape Concealer, and I am in the shade Light Medium. So I'm just going to highlight the usual spots, which is underneath my eyes, the bridge of my nose, my forehead, my cupid's bow, and my chin. And I'm also going to use this as an eyeshadow primer because I did forget to have him pick out an eyeshadow primer. I kept saying to myself, I'm not forgetting something, and I totally did not know what I forgot, but it was an eyeshadow primer. But that's okay because recently I've been loving using a concealer as an eyeshadow primer. So I'm just going to blend this out with this all new, never used, brand new L'Oreal, you know, the sponge from L'Oreal, the one I really, really love. And I'm just going to buff this and blend this out, this concealer out. When you're blending in your concealer, make sure you're always looking up and not swiping. You just pat this, like blend it in patting motion so it does not crease underneath the eye. I'm sorry if you guys can see the top of my mirror, but I'm trying to find a mirror that's kind of a little lower than this. I was able to figure out a way to stand my camera on my tripod without attaching it, but the only downside to that is that I can't tilt it. So, but that's why I've been doing a lot of videos, because I was able to finally find a way to use my camera without having it fall on me. Okay, so to set the concealer and anywhere else that I apply concealer, I'm using my all-time favorite, this is the NYX HD Finishing Powder, and this is in the shade Banana. And I absolutely love this powder. It just sets your concealer so well, and it brightens up the under eye so beautifully. I'm also going to set down that concealer under on my lid, just so all my eyeshadows apply really smoothly and they do not crease or move. I'm also going to set my foundation, and this is optional with this foundation because I feel like you don't really need to set this foundation, but I did mention in my last makeup tutorial that this became a habit of mine. No matter what foundation I use, I always like to set it with a powder, and I've only been using the Clinique Blended Face Powder, but I've been looking for another face powder to use besides this. I'm not getting bored of it, I just want to try out new things. But yeah, I really like this one now. I'm just going to set this Well, today I'm using something I've never used before, and this is, I have no idea what this is from. I think we got this in an Ipsy bag, or not a BoxyCharm bag, but there's no name or label. So sad. I have to look this up. There is a name on this cap, but I can't see it with the gold lettering, so I'm gonna definitely look it up and just list it down in the description box as well as the screen over here. But this is a brow pencil and has a spoolie on one end and the angled brow pencil on the other end. So it's kind of like similar to the Anastasia Brow Wiz, which I've never used in my life. So hopefully this goes well. And hopefully this is my shade. So I'm just gonna brush my brow hairs. I'm going to have to use a mirror for this. A close up. I'm gonna use this mirror from Tarte so I can see close up. Tidy up the edges just to make sure it doesn't look messy or anything. I'm just gonna carve it out, that's what I'm just trying to get at. I'm gonna carve out my brows and I'm using the NYX, not the NYX, the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer in the shade Medium, and I'm using this flat definer brush from Luxie. Okay guys, so I had to change a poopy diaper, but I kind of like this brow product. I don't know if it's my color or if it's the right color for my brows, but I had to get used to it because I'm actually really used to using my e.l.f. brow pencil, which is not that waxy as this one, but so far I like this one. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and move on to eyeshadows. I'm actually looking at the lip choices that my daughter picked out. She picked out a nude one and she also picked out a pinky one from Wet n Wild. So I'm thinking I'm going to do something that will go well with this lip color. So I'm going to do like a nude eye shadow for eye look, and I'm going to try to use almost all of the palettes. So she picked out this artist palette, which is actually not going to really use this because it's in limited edition or it's not available anymore, so I'm not going to use this one. So I'm just going to use the Wink Deluxe eyeshadow palette that we received in BoxyCharm a few months ago actually, and it has really really pretty colors. And I'm also going to use the Tarte Clay Play palette in volume 2, and I'm actually going to use these shades for some transition shades, but I see some matte shades on here. So by the way, this is the Winky Luxe Kitten palette, and this is just such a gorgeous palette. I love the packaging first of all, and there's some matte shadows here and some shimmery eyeshadows as well. And so I'm gonna go ahead and use this for starting it off with a transition shade. Okay, I'm gonna take the shade Stuck. I thought I said something else. But I'm gonna take this shade right here. Beautiful nude beigey shade. I'm horrible at describing colors if you guys don't know my nail. But I'm gonna take this one and use this as a crease color. And I've never used this palette before, so let's see how it goes. The shadows are very, very pigmented, is what I like. So I'm just gonna apply this all over my crease area, starting from the outer corner, and then just blending that in windshield wiper motion, and then circular motion. And then I'm just gonna build up the color as I go. My mirror is like too far away from me because I want to try not to show the top of this mirror on camera, so I have this all the way in the back of the edge of the table. I'm trying my very best not to. So I'm trying my very best to see what I'm doing without pulling the mirror closer to me. I'm just gonna bring that all the way over here because I do want to create the cat eye look. I'm just gonna bring that all the way to the end of the tail of my brow. Okay, so now I'm gonna go ahead and probably go with a shade. I'm gonna go deepen up the crease area a little bit more, and I'm gonna use a different brush, and I'm gonna go in with this bronzer shade from the Tarte Clay Palette, and this is the shade Terracotta. So technically this is a bronzer shade, but you can definitely use this however you guys would like. And I'm just gonna deepen up the crease shade a little bit, just a tad. So just gentle because these shades are very, very pigmented. So I'm just gonna blend that right on top of Strut from the Kitten palette. Okay. Now I'm gonna go and take this pretty matte, sort of like a wine shade right here, and this is the shade Cheshire. Yes. So this is just like a wine shade in the Kitten palette, and I'm just going to take that and blend that on the outer corners of my eye, and then blending that towards the crease area. But I'm not going to bring it too far up. I'm going to use this mirror from the Tarte Clay palette. I'm gonna pack this on the outer corner or the outer view of my eye.
PremiumBeat.com.
I'm actually gonna do a halo eye, come to think of it. So I'm gonna pack this on also on the inner corners of my eye. Just gonna build up the color. And I'm gonna leave the middle of the lid space to apply whatever shimmer shade I decide to go with. And I'm also going to connect the inner and outer corner together, and I'm just gonna blend that very ever so slightly. I'm just gonna connect that right there. You guys have wooden lids, and you guys can't find your lids, you can definitely just lift up your eyes just to find that lid. I mean that crease space. This shade from the Kitten palette is so, so gorgeous. But you definitely have to work your way up to build it up. Go back to the. I'm gonna mix Strut from the Kitten palette and Terracotta from the Clay palette, and just gonna blend everything together. Okay, so now I'm gonna go in with a shimmer shadow in the middle, and I'm gonna actually want to take, I'm going to try this first. This is Holographic from the Kitten palette. Just this beautiful shade right here. Like a little, I don't know what you call it, duochrome shade. The reflect, I can see like a green reflector, but it also has a purple sheen as well. So I'm going to take that on a flat shader brush from Ulta. And I'm first going to dip my brush on it dry. Tap off the excess, and I'm going to switch this with the CoverFX setting spray, or you can use any setting spray, even water, if you'd like, just to intensify this. And I'm just going to put this in the middle of my lid. definitely have to build up this color. Definitely. And I'm just gonna bring that all the way to the crease area right there. I'm gonna go back to that wine shade, Cheshire, and I'm just gonna deepen up the outer and inner corners. I'm just blending everything together. I'm gonna take more of holographic and just apply a little bit more of that on my lid because it kind of got blended away. And then I'm just gonna take this brush, I'm not gonna dip it anymore in any more product, and I'm just gonna blend out the edges. Okay, so I'm going to apply lashes today, and for today I'm gonna be using the Kiss Look So Natural lashes. I've used this before, but this is a new one, so I'm gonna have to trim this because they are really, really long and my eyes are kind of small. So I'm gonna go ahead and trim this. Okay guys, so the lashes are on. I had a little difficulty applying them because they're so big and so long, and as you can see, and they're super, super dramatic and very, very wispy. I did forget to mention before I applied the lashes that I was going to apply mascara, and for the mascara that they chose today, my kids, that is, they chose the L'Oreal Lash Paradise, and I also did curl my lashes as well. I applied the mascara on my upper and lower lashes. Now that the eyes are completely done, we're going to move ahead and finish off the rest of the face. I am going to bronze up my skin first using the Physician Formula Butter Bronzer. I absolutely love this bronzer. I think this is just in the shade Bronzer. So I'm just going to warm up my face a little bit. Also going to contour, and the contours that they showed with the NYX 3-Step Sculpting Palette, and I'm just gonna chisel out my cheekbone using the contour shade right here. Okay guys, so that is it for the video. The battery on my camera died, so I'm finishing recording this video for you guys on my iPhone. So hopefully it turned out okay. But I don't know if the part where I was highlighting my cheekbone and the part where I was putting lipstick on and everything else was recorded or was being recorded. But for my lips today, I used the Mellow Cream Lipstick, I believe in the shade Posh. And then I also set my face with the Cover FX Illuminating Setting Spray. And if the highlighter part did not go through, I did highlight my face with the Amazing and Beautiful Amazing Highlighter with Anastasia of Beverly Hills. And it's just super, super gorgeous. And I just topped that on the high point of my cheek. And I did put a headband on because my baby hairs are just out of control today. But yes, I hope you guys enjoy this video. It's super long, so I hope you guys had grabbed yourself a snack because it was pretty lengthy. But I had so much fun working with my kids and introducing my kids to you guys and including them in my videos. If you guys enjoy seeing them and would like to see more of them, please give this video a thumbs up. Or if you guys love this video, just comment down below and let me know. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button down below so you guys can stay notified, and also that notification bell so every time I upload a video, you guys will be notified. Again, thank you guys so much for watching. Oh, and before I forget, my daughter's video will be also listed down in the description box below and also on the screen right here. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.